Welcome, cruise travelers. This is Brian from the Cruise Travelers, and we are going to take you ashore to Progreso in the Yucatan Peninsula. We're going to show you how to get there, how long it takes to get there, what it costs, where you should shop, where you should eat, and how to get to the beach. So let's do it right now, guys. Here we go. Progreso by the Yucatan Peninsula, and just getting off of the Carnival Glory 5-day cruise out of New Orleans. First stop was Cozumel, and now this stop's going to be obviously Progreso. And Progreso's port is really small. It seems to be a shipping port. You'll notice on both sides of the boat that they have sort of a shipyard area. So it's not, the port isn't as well developed as, say, your Cozumel port or even Grand Turk. This one is a very small port and not a lot to do when you just get off the boat. When you just get off the boat, it's about a 3 to 5 minute walk to this, what I like to call, little pop-up business area. And a couple shops, but you have to take a 20-minute bus ride or cab ride into town to get to downtown Progreso. So I'm going to take you through the process to be able to get off the boat. Obviously, we just exited the Carnival Glory. A Carnival Glory, and when you exit the Carnival Glory, you and this is a universal port, so places like Cozumel have designated piers just for that particular cruise line. Not with this one. It is they have to schedule their boats coming in, and this particular week or this particular day is the Carnival Glory. So as you can see, we've walked probably no more than 2 minutes off the boat, and we are walking up to the pop-up town of Progreso. They always put these right at the port, more of a tourist trap than anything. This doesn't represent the local culture, the architecture. So I'm gonna take you into town. I'm gonna tell you how to get there, how much it costs, what to expect when you get there. So hang on, guys. Looking for a little bit of shopping right at the port of Progreso in the Yucatan Peninsula. Right at the end of the pier, they have little shops like this. And you can buy drinks, you can buy hats, you can buy shirts, all the touristy stuff. But if you really want to get a feel for Progreso, let's take a ride into town. I'll show you what it looks like, show you how much it costs to get there, and come along, let's go. So we're still in this little shopping district right off the pier, and a lot of little trinkets, smaller portion. We're gonna walk to the very end, get in a cab, and enjoy a ride into downtown. They always funnel you in the right direction, so don't feel like you're gonna get lost. You'll want to just sort of follow the shops. It's a winding walkway between all the shops, and so you shouldn't have a problem finding your way to the cabs. And it's called the taxi service. Let's go take a look at the rates. They should have a list. Much like what I showed you in Cozumel, they should have a list of prices for taxis. So we jumped on a bus at the transportation center at the port in Progreso. And there's a free bus called the Progreso bus tour, but yet it's not a tour, it's just called that. And it's a free bus ride into downtown, so you don't need to pay for a taxi if you don't want to. Other taxis to get into town are going to be anywhere from $8 to $10. But obviously with a free ride, this is sort of what you get. You get a bunch of people on the same bus. A lot of times they lack in air conditioning, which they are. So we'll take the bus into town, and then I'm going to take you around to see what they have to offer in downtown. Bus in Progreso, and they drop you off at what is a bus station, and they give you about a 5-minute spiel on the bus that sort of explains everything that they offer locally, the excursion they offer, and there's some interesting options, but mainly for a port like this, you may want to stick with the ship's excursions. So, hello, good. No, I'm okay, thanks. I'm just looking. So this is like a little pop-up little shopping area. Got it.
Why you better, sir? My brother.
So we, just a little shopping area, a lot of little trinkets, a little handmade items, purses, and various other items to shop for. And this is just steps off of the...
Hi, sir.
Hello. Hello. The Progreso. Oh, no, thank you. So we're doing some shopping right off of the bus here in Progreso, and want to look at all the items. Everyone wants to sell you something, which is all nice stuff. It's great to have, so it's a great option. So if you need some shopping immediately, this is an option, that's for sure. So definitely check it out. Thanks. Right when you get off the bus, you're going to notice signs to your right that say Playa Beach. And they have signs as well, and if that's where you want to end up, get off the bus, take a right, and let me show you what the free bus looks like so you understand. This is the free bus. This is the company that is the free bus from the port to downtown Progreso. So if you want to get a free ride, that's the one you do.
You like any hammock, sir?
Oh, no, thank you.
All right, man.
That's good. Oh, no, thank you. It looks good, though. Thank you. See, they have little trinkets like this. This is all really neat stuff, and stuff that you could probably only get here. For instance, your vanilla flavored stuff. Oh, I'm just looking at stuff. Oh yeah, that smells good. Let me look over here. And they have shot glasses here. It's a lot. Thank you. So they have various items here.
Let me show you this one.
Nope, I'm heading to the beach, but thank you. Everyone wants you to to buy stuff, and I can understand that. This is a country of Mexico, to where a lot of the stuff they have, they make by hand. So we're going to walk through here, through the plaza. We're going to walk over to where the beach is at. But remember, if you want your free transportation back to the port, then you'll want to do go back to the bus destination. So here in Progreso, you can rent four-wheelers or you can rent the mopeds. But I warn you, you have to be cautious, because when I was in Mexico last time, we rented a Jeep and we got stopped, and all they wanted was money. So that's not always the case, but you know, then I spoke to a gentleman at dinner a night ago, and they said they did the same thing to him. So just be cautious that you are.
How are you today?
Good. Just be cautious that you are what you're doing, and you always want to travel with a partner, unlike what I'm doing today. Michelle's enjoying the pool, which I think she should. She's deserved it. This is the beach. It's a local beach. You can get massages here. You can chill out under umbrellas. You can walk in the water. And this is only one block from the bus terminal. So you'll want to at least try out the locals area. Oh no, thank you. I'm just walking for now. Thank you though. I'm gonna take you over to the beach side, where they have tables. You can eat by the beach, you can drink a beer by the beach. They have so let's walk over by the beach, we're gonna get some of the sand, and we're gonna bounce back into town. We're gonna look at some of the shops. The water is beautiful, but you just have to get out to the water. It's not as clear as it was over in Cozumel, but oh no, thank you. But it's still beautiful. I mean, you're in Mexico right now. It's probably in the mid to low 90s. We're walking the beach. People are happy to see you, and here's the water. It's about 94 degrees out right now. A little breezy. Not too bad. Definitely makes me want to have a beer. Y'all want to have a beer? I thought so. I don't know if it's the heat, or if it is the breeze, or that I am that close to the beach. We're overlooking the beach right now, but that margarita is really good. So I am at Les Equinas. Probably butchered that one. I need Michelle right about now. She's fluent in Spanish. But I ordered the Don Julio Añejo margarita on the rocks with salt. It's just a really good margarita. It's not too sweet, has a little bit of tartness. The lime was a fresh lime when they put it in. They put salt around the rim. They charge you either by the tequila itself, or they charge you by the margarita. So the tequila itself is $7, and then the margarita is an additional $2, so it would be $9 for the margarita. But you get what you pay for. I mean, you're in Mexico, so enjoy. It's right here in Progreso, just across the street from the beach. It's a nice little spot. Nice little breeze. Great margarita. So, yeah, definitely try the place out. For Mexico, the prices are definitely a little higher than they should be, but I think if you are in these tourist areas, that's what it's going to be. You're just going to have to deal with the higher prices. Imagine if you go in several blocks into town, you're going to find that many of the restaurants and bars are much lower, but they know that we are here for convenience and they're going to charge us for that. So it is what it is. It's not a bad thing. It's just how things work out. So definitely try out that little restaurant. I didn't try any of the food. All I did was try out a margarita. It's a nice hot day. Who doesn't need a margarita on a nice hot day? And the margarita was really, really good. I don't like mine too strong or too citrusy, a little bit sweet. And it nailed all three of those. So definitely try that out. Now we're entering a little area that is a like a little shopping area. It's beautiful. Everyone's out and about. The breeze is blowing down the street. The little trinkets are here for sale. If you want a cold beer, it's here as well. So it's definitely a nice place. I mean, they have an outside cafe here. Margaritas, $2 for $5, $1 Coronas. Huh? Oh, no, thank you. I just had a margarita. Thank you, though. So it's a nice little patio area outside if you want to stop and get a drink. So definitely try it out. We're down in downtown Progreso, Mexico, and it's great. We'll be right back. that's Progreso, Mexico. That's beautiful. This is out in the streets of Progreso, and it's their native dance, I guess you could say. It's beautiful. So come try out Progreso downtown. So I made it back. It is downtown Progreso, Mexico. I was able to go through some of the shops, picked up a nice purse, and it was nice. It was fun. You're really dumped into downtown. You really feel like you're in Mexico when you're in Progreso. Some great food options, great drink options, and back at the transportation center, which is about a 7-minute walk from the beach over to the transportation center. Every 20 minutes, the free bus goes back to the boat. So every 20 minutes, you need to be at that transportation center, and that free bus will take you back to the boat. You don't need to get a taxi. You don't need to rent a car. Just simply walk to the transportation center that you were dropped off on, or if you rode a taxi into town, just ask where the bus transportation center is. It's a short walk. Jump on a free bus back to the cruise line. And it was easy. It was really easy. So definitely check out Progreso. It's one of our many stops we're going to have this summer. Don't forget to click the like button. Click that subscribe also, and that little bell button up there. That bell, what it does is every time we make a video, it sends a tiny alert in your phone and says, hey, the Cruise Travelers have a new video they've just posted, and we'll place that in our library and you can read it. You can view it, so definitely check it out. I want to thank you again for watching. My name is Brian, I'm from the Cruise Travelers, and we're going to catch you on the next cruise. Happy sailing day, guys. So long. So, tell me what you thought about Progreso. I mean, all in all, it's an okay stop. It's actually probably my least favorite destination, leaving one of the Carnival cruise ships. There's not a lot of walking area. You're hassled repeatedly from vendors, and it just wasn't as enjoyable as, say, places like Cozumel or Grand Turk. And also, when you get off the ship, you are dumped off into a military base that is not attractive at all. I mean, I'm really disappointed that Carnival still has this as a port. I try to be upfront and as frank as possible to you and try to really understand the ports, but you know, if I had a choice, I would have just skipped Progreso altogether, but I at least wanted to bring you guys some information about the port, what you can do there, how to get there, how to get back. But now you know that Progreso, just not a lot to do there. Maybe you can find something when it comes to an excursion, but as for the entire port, really wasn't that happy with it. So we have our next one coming up here in probably about 3 months. We're going to do a 14-day cruise down to the Panama Canal. We have several videos coming up here shortly, so tag along, guys. So thanks so much for staying. Hope you enjoyed the Progreso video. I wanted it to be as informative as possible. We love for them to be as positive as possible, but I want to be upfront and frank with you that, you know, if I had a choice, I would probably stay on the boat and I probably wouldn't go ashore. Maybe find an excursion, but all in all, not really happy with Progreso. So
Thanks a lot, guys. Thanks for joining us here at the Cruise Travelers. Once again, my name is Brian, and I'm with the Cruise Travelers, and we're going to see you on the high seas. See you, guys.